Do you have gum that's covering a tooth? And is that gum swollen and painful?
Which is a condition called pericoronitis.
This video will definitely help. Hi, and welcome to my channel. I'll start off by just giving a disclaimer out there and saying I am not a medical professional. This video is basically just to share my experience and hopefully it will help you. So I've had for a number of years the two back teeth, left and right side, the molars or wisdom teeth, have not fully come out, and so they are partly covered by gum. Now this wasn't an issue for a number of years, and then 2 or 3 years ago, as I was just, you know, doing my general oral hygiene, I kind of thought to myself, back there must really smell because food particles get stuck there. And I am not cleaning between the gum and the teeth where the food is getting trapped. So I therefore started looking into it to see what could I use to clean in there. And eventually, I came across these little floss brushes that I bought from Amazon. Now, these brushes I would use on other areas between teeth as normal, but I would use it just between the teeth, the tooth, and the gum, just to kind of swirl it around in there just to get food particles out. And now fast forward to January 2021. So it was on a particular day, I was eating blueberries and I think a piece of blueberry got stuck between the tooth and the gum. And it was quite irritable with my little floss brush and took it out so I could actually see the little piece come out and so forth. But I think somewhere along there, I must have hurt the gum or whatever, and then it got infected. So on that particular day, it was fine. I think it was a Friday, so everything was okay. It was just a bit like I could feel the gum. So I can't say it was pain or anything, but I could feel it. Then on the next day, it started getting a bit more. I could feel it more. The following day, it was getting worse. And now I started taking paracetamol painkiller. And I was taking that, two of them. And by the time I got to Monday, it was really painful now. So I decided to call my dentist to book an appointment. I went to see him and he could see that it was really swollen. And I think actually, like, you could actually see that my face was slightly swollen, you know, just outside my jaw, at the bottom of my jaw was kind of swollen. And when he poked that swollen bit, he could actually see a bit of pus coming out. So yeah, it was definitely infected. And again, he recommended gargling with warm water and salt, which I definitely ended up doing a lot of. And then he prescribed me antibiotics, which I went the very same day again and got the antibiotic, which I think I was taking over 10 days, it could have been, 3 times a day. And then again, he also recommended I take a painkiller if the pain is unbearable. So he recommended I take ibuprofen, which I'm not particularly a fan of it. I would rather take paracetamol rather than that. But because either the pain was becoming worse or the paracetamol was just not working anymore. So I ended up going to buy the ibuprofen, and I was taking that 3 times a day, two of them, which, yeah, under normal circumstances, I really don't like taking tablets. So, but the pain was literally becoming really unbearable. So I was having that, and it would help until it would wear out and then I'd need to take again. And I remember a particular night when I had taken, because you're not supposed to take more you're not supposed to take, you're only supposed to take them every 4 hours, and I had already used up my allocation for that day, and I really didn't want to take more, and it was painful. And I woke up in the middle of the night, and I was just on Google and YouTube, and I was trying to search, how on earth do I fix this? How do I get rid of the pain? Are there any natural remedies? So I remember seeing one article that talked about a turmeric paste, just, you know, creating a little paste and putting it on the gum. And so I did that. It might have helped a little bit, but yeah, I was desperate at that point. And sometimes what would help is drinking some water and then kind of holding the water on one side of my gum where the gum, the side that was infected. So it was all these little things that I was trying to do to just help relieve the pain. So yeah, and I don't know if I've mentioned this already, but you know, it was so swollen that if I closed my mouth, I would be kind of pressing down on that swollen gum. So anyway, I continued with the painkillers, continued with the antibiotics, until the antibiotics were finished. And I think by the time I had finished the antibiotics, the pain had now gone away. So thankfully, I had stopped taking the painkillers because I was so eager to just stop. And but funny enough, the swelling remained for quite a number of days after I had finished the antibiotics and the pain had gone and everything. So yeah, now during this whole period, I was now off solid foods because I didn't want to do anything to aggravate that swollen area. So I was having porridge and smoothies and drinking lots of water, having soups. So yeah, that was my experience. I might or might not pick up the whole idea of getting a procedure done there. It's obviously quite pricey getting your wisdom teeth removed, because obviously they charge per tooth, and in this case I've got two sides that are covered by a gum. Though it looks like the left-hand side doesn't pose as a problem, so maybe it might just be the right-hand side that I need to consider. But yeah, so I think I would just say, just be careful with the gum. Don't aggravate it. Don't do things to it that might cause infection. Speak to a medical professional to help you. And the other thing that I did as well, I then swore off using the little floss brushes for my gum, so I could continue using them for the rest of my teeth but not for where that gum is. So instead I did a bit of research, and I found I looked into water irrigators, oral dental irrigators, because I thought using water to clean that area would be better than, you know, like a brush or something. So therefore I bought this water irrigator, oral irrigator from Amazon. And so that's what I use now here and there, just to kind of get that food that gets stuck there out. So I'm going to link a video where I do a full review of that. So if you want to watch that, then that would be fine. Also, I'm just going to link the paracetamol, ibuprofen that I used, if that's going to be of help. And if you do want to use a little brush floss for your other areas of your mouth, I'll also link that in the description, and you can also buy that. But yeah, I truly hope that if you are in pain, that the pain will go away and you'll be able to find a solution. Please, if you have any questions, just drop them in the comments below, and I will help as best as I can. Thank you. Bye.